I'd like to show you how to teach your dog to stand. Not lie down like that, definitely, but stand. You may think it's not a particularly useful command. Many people don't teach it, but it's incredibly valuable for grooming your dog, take it to the vet to be examined and so on. And if you show your dog, the showing apparently expects dogs to stand rather than to sit down. So, it's not walking away. That's one thing to keep in mind about stand. I just want her to lift up and have all 4 feet on the floor. All the training I do is positive. I don't ever force dogs to do anything they don't want to do. I use what they call lure reward training and positive markers. So let me just show you what I mean. Delphi, hello, you gonna play with me? Delphi, good girl. Now the first thing to do to lure your dog into a stand is to think about how to get them up. Again, I'm gonna use a treat to start with, and I'm just gonna hold it onto her nose, right at her nose, not out here somewhere, right at her nose. I'm just gonna move it forward parallel with her nose so she gets up to follow. Good. And I'm just gonna touch her back like this, because the temptation for many dogs that have been taught to sit, and you love that, don't you, is to sit down at that point. And if you put a bit of pressure on their back, they resist it, so they're more likely to stay up. Shall we try that again? Sit? Yeah, let's do this one, shall we? Stand, good. Now, I use hand signals for absolutely everything I teach, sit. Now, because I use the flat of the hand for something else called touch, which we'll cover some other time, I use a single finger. So after a while, I still have a treat, but I'll say, stand, good girl. There's the back. But you're not standing still. She's not as good at this as she should be, so we need lots of practice. Delphi, sit. Okay, let's try the last treat. Stand. And you see, she still wants the treat. Not so sure I. Delphi's problem is that she is mixing stand with touch, which is teaching her to touch my hand. That's why I need a different hand signal. Delphi, sit. Stand. That's better. Good girl. Good stand. Good. That's it. Stand. No trees in my hand now. Good girl. Just stand still. Right. And I want to try to reinforce it because she's not terribly good at staying still. So we'll see what we can do. And what I'm going to do is put together sit, down, and stand. And not only is it going to help us understand what stand means, but it's a really good way of reinforcing all three of those commands, because if you want your dog to sit or lie down, it isn't always going to be standing or sitting quietly in front of you waiting for a command. It could be walking away, it could already be standing, it could be lying down. So if you can teach your dog in any combination of those three commands that exist, then you will proof it, if you like, for whatever you're going to ask it to do. So what I'm going to do is to get Delphi to do all three. And she doesn't really need the truth, so I'm not going to do it with the truth. She should know better, shouldn't she? So I'm going to say, okay, sit, down. Sit, stand, down. Stand, good girl. There's a good girl. Okay, well, the feet weren't glued to the floor, but that was pretty good. Oh, let's try it once again to show everybody. Okay, let's try it again. Sit, down, sit, stand, down, stand, good. Now, good girl, good girl. Eventually, I will be moving on to doing that at a distance with her. But that's the basis of it. And if you can do all three of those, particularly without treating your hand, then your dog's doing pretty well. Enjoy.